Are you tired of uneven and unrealistic modeling in Blender? Introducing proportional editing, the game-changing technique that will revolutionize your workflow. Master the art of smooth and organic modeling in just minutes. In fact, at the end of this video, you can able to create some low-poly landscapes with proportional editing. So buckle up, grab your mouse, and let's start blending. First of all, what is proportional editing? Let's just say you want to bulge in this part of the mesh. What you have to do is you have to transform the mesh by moving the vertices one by one. This will take hell a lot of time, and to be frank, ain't nobody got no time for that. Fortunately, proportional editing is here to save the day. This technique allows you to transform selected elements while also affecting nearby unselected elements. The further away an unselected element is, the less it will be impacted. Proportional editing is particularly useful when you want to create natural, organic-looking 3D models with ease. To activate this feature, simply select the proportional editing button on the 3D view toolbar or hit the hotkey O. Once activated, a circle will appear, which we like to call the circle of influence. This circle directly affects the area where the proportional editing will take place, resulting in a more organic transformation. You can increase or decrease the size of this circle by scrolling up and down. When using proportional editing, there are two types of areas to take into consideration: the area that you have selected and the rest of the area in the mesh. What happens between these two parties of geometry will largely be determined by your proportional falloff selection. There are 8 different falloff modes available in proportional editing, with smooth being the default option. To better understand how the falloff modes work, let's consider a grid of 20 by 20 sections. If we select a vertex and move it upwards using proportional editing while in side view, we can observe the smooth curve that is created as a result. This same process can be applied to all 8 modes of proportional editing. To toggle through all of your falloff options, simply use the Shift plus O shortcut. Proportional editing in Blender offers 2 additional options that can enhance your editing experience, which are available only in edit mode. The first option is called Connected Only. Imagine you have deleted all the vertices in the middle of your model, leaving 2 separate parts. With Connected Only turned off, moving one vertex will also move the other, even though they are not technically connected. However, with this option enabled, you can only move the connected points, providing greater precision and control. The second option is called Projected from View. When this feature is turned off, moving a vertex will simply move that vertex and its nearby vertices. However, when you enable Projected from View in an orthographic view, you will notice a significant difference. This option allows you to move vertices in a way that is more aligned with the camera's perspective, resulting in a more accurate and realistic representation of your model. Proportional editing is a powerful tool that can be used not only in edit mode, but also in object mode. This technique allows you to move multiple objects at once, making it a time-saving feature. Additionally, proportional editing can be used to scale and rotate objects in a more organic way. One thing to keep in mind is that proportional editing must be toggled on for each mode separately. For example, if you turn on proportional editing in object mode by hitting the O key, it will not automatically be turned on when you switch to edit mode. You must toggle it on again in edit mode if you want to use it there. Pressing Tab to switch back to object mode once again also turns on proportional editing, since it is on for that mode. In simple, you have to toggle proportional editing for each and every mode you get into. At times, even after activating proportional editing, the circle of influence may not be visible. This is often due to the circle's size being too large. To adjust the size of the circle, simply scroll up the mouse. Additionally, the size of the circle can be viewed at the top of the screen. Another thing to consider is that the center of this circle of influence tends to shift depending on the pivot point we choose. For instance, if the pivot point is set to 3D cursor, the circle's center will be wherever the 3D cursor is located. The same is true for active element and median pivot point modes. If you encounter any issues with proportional editing, ensure that your pivot point is correctly set. It's time to put our newfound knowledge into practice. let's create a stunning low-poly rocky mountain terrain. Begin by randomly selecting any vertex and moving it up using the random mode. Repeat this process a few times to create your first low-poly landscape. You can also experiment with other types of terrain by randomly selecting a vertex and moving it up using the smooth mode. This technique can produce some truly captivating low-poly landscapes. If you're eager to learn more about Blender, be sure to check out our tutorial on target selection. And that's a wrap on our exploration of proportional editing in Blender. We hope you've gained valuable insights and learned some tips and tricks for using this tool effectively. Stay tuned for more Blender tutorials, and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for future updates. Thanks for watching, and happy blending!